Virtual home visit for a child with medical complexity, post-discharge considerations, by Dr. Kathleen Huth in the Virtual Home Visit Working Group.
The transition from hospital to home can be particularly challenging for children with medical complexity. High-quality discharge planning involves ensuring medications and equipment are available to the family, coordinating close follow-up, and communicating clearly with caregivers as well as with school, home nursing, and community agencies where applicable. We asked Jack's family about some of the issues they have faced after discharge.
They want it and the pharmacy doesn't, so they write a prescription, and probably half the time it's not a traditional prescription. So the thing is, pharmacies don't carry a lot of things in inventory that you think they would right away. So sometimes it may take a couple days for them to get it and order it. And then you're dealing with insurance issues sometimes because, oh, it was written for a 30-day supply, but we only fill a 90-day supply. So you have all those things that they don't think of. And then they think, oh, well, with equipment companies, we called them. But sometimes they don't respond in a timely manner, or it's a day or so later, or the equipment arrives, or when do you actually get the training on it? Because, you know, it's all well and good. And we're kind of hands-on people, so I want to be involved. But you don't do it. You're not doing it daily. And then you get home, and then you're still trying to figure, and the people from like New England Home Therapies and stuff, you get a quick 10 minutes on it, and then you're left to still figure it out on your own. I think that is super hard. And I feel fortunate. We ask a lot of questions, and we're not afraid. And not everybody's equipped to be that way. So I think that's a really big challenge. Then also, it's not just us that have to learn it. We have nurses that then we need to teach it to. And then teach it how it goes in the routine. And you set structures, because then there's standards. And they have a parent company that they need to report to. And they have different regulations. And then you may do it a little differently. So that's challenging. And then there's, most of the time, there's a third layer, because there's school nursing too. So like, what actually does some of it carry over into school? Oh, do they need an order for that? We can't do anything until you get this from the doctor. Or it doesn't work in the daily routine. And then how does it incorporate into your home? Like, they, like if it's a piece of equipment, you know, we're super grateful that we got a chest vest and cough assist, but these are big pieces of equipment. Like, how do you keep them? Where do you put them? Where do they go? How do you teach? So there's a whole heck of a lot of considerations. And, you know, I think a lot of your, most time it's major illnesses that you're dealing with. So you're kind of shell-shocked, and then you're going home, and it's, most of it's just like on a piece of paper. And there's, usually there's specialists involved. And when you're getting discharged, those specialists aren't discharging you. It's the overall doctor. So they don't know all the finer nuances. And I think that's a real struggle.
Children with medical complexity are at high risk of having issues post-discharge. Being post-operative is one risk factor, as the child may have new equipment needs, new accessibility needs, and they may have pressure injury or need specialized dressing supplies. Another risk factor is having a new or changed diagnosis, or a new or more involved home care need due to a change in clinical status. A child with a history of frequent readmissions is at higher risk of issues post-discharge. As well, the social situation is important to consider. Jack has home nursing support, consistent caregivers, and an accessible home for his medical equipment, which is not always the case. Yet his family faces many common issues in the transition from hospital to home. Common issues that arise post-discharge may include prescription issues. Families may be unable to obtain a medication due to issues with prior authorization or lack of availability of the needed formulation at the pharmacy. Sometimes incorrect medication may be prescribed by the discharging team. It may be unclear who is responsible for refills, and families may be unsure who to contact after discharge, causing delays in administering medication. There may be issues with medical equipment. There may be problems obtaining supplies in a timely fashion, or it may arrive and may be unable to fit in the home. There may also be a lack of education on the use of new medical equipment. Caregivers may face issues with the feeding regimen, particularly with mixing new formulas. Wound care can be challenging after discharge, especially if there is difficulty obtaining supplies and the family is not informed on who to call to arrange the delivery or for refills. Families also often face challenges in scheduling timely follow-up appointments. Consider the following when discharging a child with medical complexity from the hospital. Are there any new or changed medications? Children may have important medications intentionally or unintentionally withheld during an admission and are at increased risk for unintentional medication discontinuation following hospital discharge. Is there any new medical equipment? Consider whether the family will receive the new equipment upon their return home after discharge. You should also inquire if there are any issues with the use of the equipment. For example, if the family has received a new lift for safe transfers, ask the family if it fits in the room. Have they been shown how to use it? And do they have the accompanying equipment, such as an appropriately sized sling? Are there changes in the child's clinical status and home care needs? Does the child have appropriate follow-up and contingency plans? And is there any information that needs to go to the school or community providers? Families are often faced with needing to educate and provide new orders for all of the community providers that care for the child. Follow-up of a child with medical complexity after discharge should occur within 48 hours. You should review and reinforce discharge instructions, perform a medication reconciliation, evaluate home care needs, perform a physical examination of the child, assess the accessibility of the home, and assess the social environment.